Okay, you're rolling.
Yes, we are.
Our special music guests today are such an established British institution, they really need very little introduction. But as they're celebrating 25 years in the music business, we'll give them one anyway. They've had an incredible 38 British hit singles, of which 21 went to the top 10. They spent 365 weeks in the British charts. They like talking in this. How many?
14.
What did I just say?
38.
Get your facts.
They've had 40.
Right,
can we go back? They've had 40 British hit singles. Of which 20, how many went in the top 10?
That's right. Yeah.
21 went in the top 10.
Got that right.
They spent 365 weeks in the British charts. Their worldwide record sales exceed 100 million. They're each worth £6 million.
Can we go now?
This morning.
That was last
Let's say welcome to Francis Rossi and Rick Parfitt of Status Quo.
Morning.
Sorry, worth £5 million.
Yeah. Well, between us.
Yeah.
That's how they say.
And it all started, what, a rainy night at Butlin's Minehead, was it?
You have it down as a rainy night. We were there for a few. Richard was there for 7 months. I was there for about 3 or 4 months. He used to come and watch us and show off and stand.
I needed more rehearsing than he did. You see, we were in two separate bands
at the time. Yeah.
I was in a band called The Highlights.
No, super. That's
you were in The Highlights.
Super. Mm,
were you? What happened to The Highlights?
Not a lot. Over the years, not a lot. No.
They'll and, kill you when they see you for that.
I'd finished rehearsals one evening and I remember hearing this din coming out of the rock ballroom. So I sort of wandered over there and introduced myself. Hello, my name's Dick, do you like it?
He said that.
Or my name's Rick, really.
Yeah.
And, sorry about that.
You won't be coming back here anymore.
No, no. And we've been together ever since. Lovely, isn't it? Isn't that lovely?
What a brilliant story, isn't it, really? It's emotional, isn't it?
Well, I mean, you say it's emotional. Is there, I mean, we're people like us say, well done, congratulations, 25 years in the industry. Does it actually mean anything to you? Is it just another year? Just keep carrying on?
Just another year. No, I think it is the fact that we've been around that long. If nothing else, we've done that. You know, it probably is nothing else but that.
Mm.
But it's an achievement, I think, to be around that long.
But over the years, I think it's fair to say we haven't thought about it, you know. I mean, it's just get out there and get on with it, you know. Mm. And 25 years have literally gone past. Mm. It's really.
Talking about highs and lows. I mean, was there a great period for you, or what do you feel was your best period, or do you just view it as a plateau? Just keep saying.
Well, there was. We're still waiting for the best period to come. I think. I don't know. There hasn't been a best period. I suppose it was pretty hot around the Rocking All Over the World era. You know, but I still think there's more to come.
And how have you boys come through it unscathed?
Oh, us unscathed.
Yeah. Well, all right, partially scathed.
Look, what's the matter with you? Unscathed.
You can't see us from the hips down.
No, sorry. We had the what's name problems. We can't mention that on TV, do we?
You can.
Yeah,
you can
talk to Hillary
about
it.
Talk
to Hillary about it.
I keep meeting him in the toilet every time we come here. I meet the doctor in the toilet. He's a funny man. I shouldn't have said that either. Shall I go now?
No, you're doing extremely well.
I'll tell you what, you look great in the boots. I saw you in the boots last week.
On Gary Glitter's boots? They were, yes. They were very difficult, though. I couldn't have walked in them.
We all wore them through the 70s. We wore them as well.
The same boots.
And they were very tricky. They were very tricky.
Were they as high as that, though?
On you, though.
Were Gary's not a
didn't
bit
they?
Over
That's
the
not what
tall?
You said to me.
No. It made you a lot taller.
It made you a lot taller as well.
I know, a lot taller, I suppose.
Is it news time yet?
No, it's not.
No,
we're
not.
Working
it's
up to the news.
It's video time though, nearly.
Yes, as ever, you boys have been seen all over the place, Top of the Pops, and the music you've been playing. Let's hear it again. It's the 25th anniversary single from Status Quo, and there seems to be something here for just about anyone who can remember the last 25 years. Here's Anniversary Waltz.
Hey baby, won't you take a chance? Say that you'll let me have this dance, so let's dance.
me at the wheel. I stole a kiss at the turn of a mile. My curiosity's running wild. Cruising and playing the radio with no particular place to go. Riding along my kind of blues, still trying to get her belt loose. All the way home I held a grudge, but the safety belt it wouldn't budge. Cruising and playing the radio with no particular place to go.
Great. I was playing
You've got down off the sofa.
Yes, I was playing my imaginary guitar there with great gusto. That was good, wasn't it?
It was good. Yeah. We saw some of the compilation, but yeah. How many songs did you actually start with before you made the selection and whittled it down?
Well, we were asked to pick the 25 or as many songs as we could that we've liked over the last 25 years. And, of course, we ended up with, 40, 50 songs. And after a lot of sort of grey matter and deliberation and
that's
whatever, we got it down to, I don't know, how many, 11, 12, 12 tracks on the...
Was there a tussle? Was there one track somebody wanted on and...
There was a lot of that. That was the best, the way it came about was the band thrashing it out. It got down to four sides and three sides, then there were packaging problems, marketing problems.
Bit tricky, three problems. Sides, you know.
It was.
Three
it?
Sides of a record.
We eventually got it all the way down to this. It was very good.
Very tough time.
Yeah,
took a lot of work.
Is it news time yet?
Well, it's certainly pretty
popular.
No, it's
popular, not news time yet. Oh, well, you sorry. Stop saying
you just want your
time.
Breakfast, don't you?
Yeah, I'm having a breakfast here.
Want a cup of tea?
It's going to be a bonus. Yeah. It's supposed to be good, isn't it?
It's weather.
It's very good. It's nearly free.
Get ready.
Weather.
Time for the weather with Nikki, our travel producer. Good morning, Nikki. We enjoying that sort of music? Good stuff.
Yes, I've got a good old bop here in the corner, but I'm going to stand perfectly still now and tell you what the weather's like. It's going to be quite wet and windy to start with up in Scotland, as it has been all week. That's going to continue a little longer, but hang on in there. There's good news coming up for those rainy areas. This morning the rain will be quite heavy in the west of Scotland, but in the east and in Northern Ireland it should be a little more patchy, not quite as heavy. England and Wales should have another dry, sunny morning once a few misty bits have cleared up. This afternoon, that rain in Scotland and Northern Ireland will just start to edge south into Northern England, which means that northwest of Scotland should get a few sunny spells starting to creep in. Most of England and Wales still dry with some sunshine and quite a warm day. Temperatures start at 13 Celsius, that's 55 in the far north, rising to 21 Celsius, that's a lovely warm 70 in parts of the south. This evening, it'll stay cloudy with outbreaks of rain over most of Scotland, Northern Ireland and Northern England, again as that band of weather creeps very slowly south. The rest of England and Wales should stay dry and mainly clear, and it'll be a mild night for all. The outlook for tomorrow, continuing pretty much as today with that band of wet, windy weather creeping slowly south. By Sunday, Scotland will be much brighter and England and Wales will be wetter and windier. Monday, much the same as Sunday, but with some rain again reaching the northwest of Scotland, so the fine weather not lasting very long. Tuesday, that rain spreading right across Scotland and Northern Ireland, but a dry day again for England and Wales. Mike, back to you.
Well done, thank you. You looked almost exhausted at the end of that. But it was a clear round, the jury says. Good morning, Britain. It's coming up to 8 o'clock on Friday, the 28th of September. I'm Mike Morris.
And I'm Lorraine Kelly.
I'm
in the
Rick
next half hour. That's right, you're Rick Parfitt, he's Francis Rossi. Just so
news.
That we all know.
It's the news now.
Yeah, well, we say it's slightly more formal,
isn't
it?
It keeps wanting the news in a wee second. In the next half hour, we'll be speaking with Christopher Shope MP, the Minister for Roads and Traffic, as we wrap up our child safety drive.
And we'll be speaking to these two young rockers, Francis and Rick,
I like that.
Young from status quo. I had a young.
We love it when we come sort of
these two rockers.
Okay, 8 o'clock, let's get the latest national and international news now with Lisa Ashley. Good morning.